In this segment, we'll talk about how can we find eigenvalues of a square matrix through an example. So let's suppose somebody says, hey, find eigenvalues of this square matrix right here. It gives you 3, minus 1.5, minus 0.75, and 0.75. So if these are, this is the matrix which is given to you and you're asked to find the eigenvalues of this matrix, then we know that, hey, determinant of A minus lambda I should be equal to 0, where A is this square matrix right here. So that what we're saying is determinant of 3 minus 1.5 minus 0.75 plus 0.75 minus lambda I, which is 1, 0, 0, 1, is equal to 0. If we do the matrix subtraction, I'm going to get something like this. I'm going to get 3 minus lambda, because lambda is right here, minus 1.5, because minus 1.5 minus lambda times 0 is that quantity itself, minus 0.75, and 0.75 minus lambda. So that's what we get by when we subtract the two matrices. So we have to find the determinant of this matrix and put that equal to 0. Determinant of a 2x2 matrix is simple. You simply multiply this by this and subtract what you get from the product of this and this. So that turns out to be then 3 minus lambda times 0.75 minus lambda minus 1.5 times minus 0.75 is equal to 0. And if we expand this, this is what we're going to get. We're going to get lambda square minus 3.75 lambda plus 1.125 equal to 0. And as you can see here that we have a 2x2 matrix of which we are trying to find the eigenvalues, and what we are getting is a second order polynomial equation. We've got a second order polynomial here and equal to 0. So it's a quadratic equation, so everybody knows how to find the solution of a quadratic equation. So it is lambda minus of b minus 3.75 plus minus square root of minus 3.75 square minus 4ac, which is a is 1, c is 1.125, divided by 2 times 1 right here. So based on this, we get 3.75 plus minus 3.092 divided by 2. And so we'll have over 2 roots, which get 3.421, and we get 0.3288. So those are the two eigenvalues we have. So lambda 1 is 3.421, lambda 2 is 0.3288 as the two eigenvalues of this particular square matrix. And that is the end of this segment.